Please welcome Cherish the Ladies.
Excited to be out playing live music. It's unreal. We don't know ourselves. And we are so happy. I think we was like something like 566 days between gigs, so I can't tell you how happy we are to see you sitting out there. So thank you very much. And a big hello to all the folks at home, too, that are watching us. Anyway, we just played in the Troy Music Hall last night in Troy, New York. But now we're here. Yay! And we're ready for you. Are you ready for us? Yay! All right. Here we go.
On Christmas night, good people sing to hear the news the angels bring. On Christmas night, good people sing to hear the news the angels bring. News of great joy, news of mirth, news of our merciful King's birth. When sin departs before thy grace, then life and health come in its place. When sin departs before thy grace, then life and health come in its place.
Angels and men with joy may sing, all for to see the newborn King.
Woo! you. Woo! Are we getting you in the Christmas spirit yet? Oh, let me tell you, we're gonna get you by the end of the show. We're telling you right here and now. How about saying hello to our two fantastic dancers for you folks? And these are both dancers. They're from the Donegal School of Irish Dancing. Both of them are regional, and they've gone in the nationals and the worlds. They've been all over the place. On your left, all the way from the great state of Staten Island. Staten Island, New York. Please welcome Caitlin Ward, folks. Caitlin Ward. All right, Caitlin. And her partner in crime. And I have to say, both of them are seniors in college. So their parents are thrilled that they are out making some money, instead of having their hands out all the time, as they're so good at. But anyway, on your right, Noel. That's Noel Spillane, folks. Noel, again, all the way from Long Island, New York. Give him a big round of applause. All right, Noel. Noel and Caitlin. Well, anyway, we're so happy to be here, and it's always one of our favorite venues. We love to play at the Sellersville, and we're so even happier this time to come back with a wonderful singer who sang with us for the beginning of our career, 7 years of which she was with the band, and then went on to form a great, incredible solo career that she has done such a mighty job. And I think she's one of the most beautiful voices ever to sing an Irish song. How about I give a nice, warm welcome to Miss Cathie Ryan, all the way from Detroit, Michigan.
Thank you, Joanie. It is great to be in Pennsylvania. It seemed a sure thing 2 years ago when looking at the road and the future that I would definitely be in Pennsylvania again. And then everything went wallop, as we would say. So it's really great to be back. And this is such a beautiful area. The drive here was gorgeous. And it began to snow when we got to the venue. So we're gonna sing a song now about the coming of snow. It was written by a Dublin songwriter for Cherish the Ladies. His name is Maurice McGrath. And he woke up one Christmas morning in Ardra in County Donegal, and the snow was falling all over the town, and the song came to him. It's called All the Valley Down. The white winter snow is falling on the town. The wind from the west is blowing all around. The dark of night will fade in time. Soft will come the day. So rest your soul, lay down your head. Tomorrow snow is falling on the town. The wind from the west is blowing all around. The dark of night will fade in time. Soft will come the day. So rest your soul, lay down your head. Tomorrow Thank you so much, and I love Gabriel with the snow, piano snow.
What about Cathie Ryan, folks? Let's hear for Cathie. Thank you very much. I know we're watching from home, but Matt, our lovely sound engineer, how does it sound out there? We'll give Matt a round of applause. He's doing a great job. Matt, we have the fiddle. Her fiddle DI is cacking up a bit. Should we use the microphone? Do you think we should use the mic? Okay, sure, yeah. All right, just use the mic. Yeah, that'll do. And if you're, all right. Well, listen, folks, I don't know if you know that myself and Mary Coogan, we're just about to celebrate 37 years together in the band, and next week, 2 weeks. So I always thought that Mary had great taste in people. And I also have to say she has great taste in husbands, because not only did she get a great husband, but she got a husband who sings, and he sings beautifully. And we thought it'd be lovely if he came up and joined us for a couple of songs. How about a big warm welcome, please, for Mr. Bruce Foley, all the way from Buffalo, New York.
Thank you, Joanie. Okay, Joanie asked if I could do a nice classic song, because this Christmas time is time to look back, reminisce, and she said if I could do something to, you know, instill the, or bring the Christmas spirit out. And I was telling her the spirit has to go in before the spirit comes out. But I see a few people are out there doing that already, so. We have a beautiful song here from 1847 here called O Holy Night, and if you know it, sing along, please. The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope
The weary world rejoices, for yonder her brings a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, O hear the angel voices, O night divine, O night when Christ was born, O night divine, O night, O night divine. Led by the light of faith, serenely beaming with glowing hearts, by his cradle we stand. So led by light of a star sweetly gleaming, here come the wise men from the Orient land. The King of Kings lay thus in lowly manger, in all our trials, born to be our friend. Fall on your knees, O hear. Christ was born, oh, night divine, oh, night, oh, night divine. Thank
you very, very much. And a big shout out to all my relations out in Western Pennsylvania and my family all around that are watching the streaming. Thank you.
Bruce Foley, come on, give it a round of applause to Bruce. My man, Bruce. One, two, three, go. those were a couple of tunes from the 1700s there. And the middle one is a lovely tune by Turlough O'Carolan called Planxty Baptist Johnson. It was written in 1728. And the last tune is one called Oscar and Malvina. It was written for a play in the 1700s. So there you go, the girl dancing to the jigs over there of the 1700s. Well, listen, we're going to carry on. First off, I'd like to introduce the rest of the group to you, if that's okay. All right. Well, on my left once again is the wonderful Mary Coogan, folks. Mary's from Newburgh, New York. Mary's from Newburgh, and her mother emigrated from Ireland, from Castlereagh in County Roscommon. And her music stems from her dad, Jim, who's a great accordion player, and that's where she picked up her music. He was a lovely man, and he raised a lovely daughter, because she's one of the nicest people you'll ever meet. And in addition to being a fantastic musician, she's also a wonderful teacher, not just of banjos and guitars and mandolins, but she also has a master's degree in education, was a Catholic school teacher for many, many years before getting onto the bandwagon of musician. One of the nicest people. Say hello to Mary Coogan, folks. And on the fiddle, only here a few days now. She's all the way from County Cork in Ireland. Take it easy out there. That's her uncles. No, this is Nollaig Casey, and Nollaig is all the way from Bandon in County Cork. Again, from a very, very musical family. Her sisters are amazing musicians. Her sister Mairead, and also her sister Maura. Maura Nakaza, one of the finest harpists ever play, and her parents were singers in the whole nine yards, past the music and the poetry down to Nollaig. She's an amazing musician. She's played with everybody from Planxty to Riverdance to Van Morrison, you name it. She's also toured with the Chieftains. She didn't tour with them. Did you tour with them? No, you played with them. Well, anyway, she toured with the Clancy Brothers. She toured with the Clancy Brothers, and she was touring along with a guitar player by the name of Artie McGlynn, one of the finest guitarists Ireland ever produced, and she wound up marrying him. So she got more of a paycheck from that tour. She also got a husband. Anyway, honest to God, what a great fiddle player. Say hello to Nollaig Casey, everybody. And in the Galway section over there, first up is Mirella Murray. Mirella is from Connemara, a place called Clatidduff, just outside of the beautiful town of Clifton. Yeah, Mirella! And Mirella, amazing musician. As Nollaig is All-Ireland champion, and so is Mirella, and incredible musician. And the music stems from her dad, who was really the driving force, and her mom, too, knew all the words to every song. But her dad, a great step dancer, Sean Noe's old-style dancer, and wherever there was a tune, he was there and dragging Mirella around, and she heard the best, and she became the best. All-Ireland champion. Say hello to Mirella Murray, everybody. Here we go. We don't know who the heck this guy is, no. Our piano player, Kathleen Boyle, is about to give birth any day now, so we're
it's
holding...
It's not my fault.
It's not your fault, yeah. But we are
I
so...
can't help it.
We are so thrilled to have Gabriel Donohue. Well, Gabriel's a man I've been playing with since I was 18 years old. We first met, and he was when he emigrated from County Galway, Athenry in County Galway. And we've been playing music ever since together. And that's he's right. One of my best friends and an incredible musician, not just a great musician, but a producer. And he's also a ranger, and he plays vocals and guitars and mandolins and banjos and accordions.
All right, that's enough, Joe.
Yeah, but then sometimes he plays the whistle, and that's when I get angry.
Oh, she gets angry.
So, but besides that, he's good at everything else besides the whistle. He should leave that home. But anyway, but he is really an amazing musician, and he toured with the Chieftains for many, many years. And he's so much happier playing with us because he says we are way better looking than them. Let's hear for Gabriel Donohue, everybody.
I'll stop.
And if you don't know who I am, my name is Joanie Madden, and I was born in the Bronx. Woo! And then raised up in Yorktown Heights up in Westchester, New York. And my mother's from County Clare, a place called Milltown Malbay. That's right. And my dad emigrated from County Galway, from Portumna in the East Galway. And my father was a brilliant accordion player, All-Ireland champion in his day. And we had a wonderful moment between us because I won my first All-Ireland 25 years to the day after my dad at the same age. So wasn't that nice of a passing of the torch? I'm Joanie Madden. Nice to meet you all. Well, we love to celebrate and sing the Christmas carols. We love to celebrate the music and the dancing and the songs. But we also love to celebrate the Irish language on this show. And Nollaig is fluent Irish speaker. So we thought it'd be lovely to get Nollaig to sing a song for you in Irish. What do you think of that? Nollaig Casey, everybody.
Hello, everybody. So I'm going to sing a lovely old Christmas carol in the Irish language. Well, it's a hymn. Well, it's a carol, I suppose. The words were written in the 1600s. I learned this from my mother. And it tells the story of the nativity and of the angel appearing to the shepherds in the sky and telling them to go to the stable in Bethlehem. So it's called Donohue Ud in Mehel, which means that night in Bethlehem.
Fast the false serpent.
We're going to continue this time with a very old piece of music from the 1700s. I found it in a book. You know, we the first time I got a phone call from a promoter, he said, "Joni, do you guys have a Christmas show?" And I said, "Of course we have a Christmas show." And then I hung up the phone. I called the girls and said, "Oh my God, we got to get a Christmas show together." And so since that time, we did the first tour and we recorded an album. We've now made 4 Christmas albums to keep everybody happy. Every year, we have that one, we want another one. So anyway, we did a lot of research looking for old stuff and new stuff. But we were trying to find a tune to go with this next carol because I really think the Celtic instrumentation and the melodies really go so well with the Christmas season tunes. And I found this piece of music from a book of Munster Pipers from County Clare. And this is a tune, I said, "Oh my God, that's going to go perfect." And then I looked up at the title and I saw it was The Poor Distressed Soldier. Really doesn't have too much of a title of a Christmas title. But you know what, as I said, you know, there's so many of our friends that are in the military who aren't home for Christmas. So it's always nice to send one out to all of them who can't be home for Christmas and say a thank you to all those men and women who did all their service for the country. Thank you very much. So we hope you like this one. It's called The Poor Distressed Soldier.
Thank you.
echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Shepherds, why this jubilee? Why your joyous strains prolong? What the gladsome tidings be which inspire your heavenly song?
You were very good. You were almost loud as the 700 people we had in Troy last night. You were so powerful. Well, listen, we're going to carry on with the tune. It's actually not a Christmas tune, but it's a tune that I wrote on Christmas night. Is that good enough? Okay, good, thank God, because we didn't know what else we would do. No, but this is a tune that I wrote. When we were starting out, after a couple of years, we were very, very lucky to meet up with the Clancy brothers. And remember the Clancy brothers? Right? Well, they were so good to us, and we toured with them for a couple of years. And it gave us great advice and really helped and guided us. But years later, we were signed to RCA Victor Records, and we were recording an album called The Girls Won't Leave the Boys Alone. And
still
I
don't.
We still won't, yeah. And I thought it'd be great to involve the Clancys, and I called them up and asked them would they sing a song, and they said if they'd love to, because they would. But we just could not come up with a day where we were available, and so were they. And it wound up that I finally got a phone call from Liam Clancy, and he says, Mad One. And I don't know why he called me that, but he says, Mad One, I have the date. Because the record was due the first week of January, so we were down to the deadline. He said, December 26th. I said, that's perfect, Liam. We're off. And he says, yeah, but you have to come to Ireland. And I said, oh, my God. So I meant myself and our producer, Brian Keane, had to fly out on Christmas night over to Ireland. And we left Kennedy Airport. And we made our beeline for Shannon Airport in County Clare. And everything was the normal flight, you know, scenario. We took off, everything was fine and dandy. And about an hour, it started getting a little rocky. And then it got really rocky. And, of course, the fasten seatbelt sign came on. And then about a few minutes later, I mean, I never heard, I thought, oh, this thing is really, we were diving and we were shooting up and we were diving down. And anyway, the captain announced that we were heading into the worst storm to hit Europe in over 100 years. And that every airport had been closed and every plane had been diverted, except ours. And there would be nobody let out of their seats the remaining of the journey. There would be no bathroom. There'd be no drinks. There would be no dinner. There'd be no nothing. And I'm telling you, I was never so frightened in my life. The plane was dipping and shooting up and dipping down, and people started screaming and roaring and hallelujahs, and everything was going on around us. And next thing I look right back, and this big fight broke out a few rows back, and I turn around, and there's this man, and he's wrestling a nun for her rosary beads. It got so bad. Well, needless to say, we finally touched down in Ireland. I thought I was going to die on Christmas. I said, this is ridiculous. I'm going to die on Christmas night because of a song. Anyway, we finally landed down, and you know, usually there's a big welcome. Welcome to Ireland, and we are, oh, and nobody said a word. We were just like, oh, dear God. And finally, the captain came on to inform us over the intercom that we had beat the Concorde. We flew over in 4 hours and 2 minutes. We didn't fly to Ireland. We were blown there. Anyway, we were in so early. Our producer, Brian Keane, he had never been to Ireland before, but his grandparents had emigrated from County Clare, from the west of County Clare, called Loophead. And he said to me, you know, Joanie, if you don't mind, he says, I would love to go stand where my grandparents left. I don't know when I'll ever get back to Ireland again. So I said, come on, Brian, let's go. So off we go. It's like 5 o'clock in the morning after we got the bags, and we headed off. And all I can tell you is that there was roads flooded and trees down and power lines down, but we were going sightseeing. Anyway, it's pitch black. Well, we finally got down there, and I couldn't believe it. The road we got down to see Loophead, there was a big, massive tree right across. No way could we get down the road. So I saw on that little map they give you from the cars, I said, well, it looks like there's another road there. So we went down to that road, and there was a massive flood. No way in heck could we go past that road. So we turned around, and now we've come so far. We're so close. And Brian says to me, maybe, because where else can we go? And I said, let's just drive down here, and we'll see what we find. And sure enough, there's a signpost, and it says Kilkee, 6 miles. So I said, right, Brian, let's go to Kilkee. It's almost 6 o'clock. There'll be somebody going to Mass, and we can ask somebody how the hell to get out there. So anyway, we got to Kilkee, but we didn't find anybody to go into Mass. We found no sinners. But what we did find, you know, Kilkee is this beautiful little village on the west coast of County Clare, and it's magnificent. The cliffs there are just beautiful. And because of the bad, bad storm, and the waves, they were crashing in against the shoreline. It was just absolutely mesmerizing. It was just spectacular. And dawn was just breaking, and the sky was the reds and the blues and the greens and the yellows and the purples. And myself and Brian were just gobsmacked by this view. And I said, Brian, I think God is saying sorry about last night. Here you go. And myself and Brian got out of the car, and I got the whistle out, and Brian got the guitar, and we wrote this little tune on St. Stephen's Day, Boxing Day in Ireland, and we called it The Waves of Kilkee. So I hope you can see what we saw that morning. I'm going to send this out to the Volachs down there. Thank you. the old ways of Kilkee. We got Cathie and Bruce back, the two this time. We're getting two for the price of one.
Yes, but before we launch into another beautiful song, I just want to take a moment. That tune you heard, composed by Joanie, is one of many beautiful songs that she has written, many beautiful tunes, and that have gone into the tradition and that will live long. And it's not only that Joanie has given to Irish music, she's given her life to it through this band and through all the work she has done to promote Irish music and culture, not just in the United States, but all over the world. And in honor of that, this year, 2021, President Biden has awarded Joanie Madden with the National Heritage Award.
She's a national treasure.
Thank you, Cathie.
She got a standing ovation last night, by the way, for that.
Here we go. Oh, Gabe, will you stop?
That was Troy, New York.
Thank you very much. All right, Cathie, get singing.
But it takes not just talent and people who love the music, but to powerhouse the tradition for over 40 years.
All right, Cathie,
it's true.
All right, just get going.
It's true. Well-deserved award. Thank you, Joe Biden. We are going to ask you to sing with us. Is that okay? I heard a very hearty man, yet they're roaring.
The rest.
Outstanding. Will you lead the way?
The rest of them stink.
Will you sing with us?
Yeah. Right.
Beautiful. We're going to keep in the Clancy theme. We're going to sing a song that was written by a nephew of the Clancy brothers, great singer and songwriter who graced us for many, many years, and we hope he's still writing songs, Robbie O'Connell. Yes, and he wrote this song all on a Christmas morning, and it's kind of a call and response. Myself and Bruce will sing a line. We'll all sing a line together. We'll sing one more line, and you'll join us. And your lines are, just as the day was dawning, and all on a Christmas morning. So will we try a run of it?
They look confused.
All right, we'll break it down. How about sing this with me? Just as the day was dawning. Try that. Just as the day was dawning. Beautiful. And all on a Christmas morning. Try that. All a Christmas morning. I think you've got it.
They're ready.
Beauteous.
I don't think they're ready, but we'll try it.
Just jump in.
Kings came riding from the east.
Just as the day was dawning,
the newborn king of kings to
on
see.
All on a Christmas morning,
a fiery star it guided them.
Just as the day.
Just as the day was dawning,
it brought them.
All on a Christmas morning.
They came unto a stable bare.
Just as the day was dawning,
and found the newborn infant there,
all on a Christmas morning.
Then down upon their knees they fell.
Just as the day was dawning,
the baby sweetly smiled.
Christmas morning. They gave him to be
Come on, you got it now.
Just as the day was dawning,
of frankincense and myrrh and gold,
all on a Christmas morning,
three kings came riding from the east.
Just as the day was dawning, the newborn King of Kings to see, all on a Christmas morning, all on a Christmas morning, all on a Christmas morning.
You sounded beautiful. Thank
that
you.
That was gorgeous singing.
That was great. Let's hear it for Cathie and Bruce, everybody. Beautiful.
Beautiful. My granddaughter would say, that was awesome.
Well, listen, we're going to do one more for you now and take a little break for yourselves. You can, I'm sure you all need a drink after that. And we have some, there's the bars open up there, and we also have some CDs out there. Cathie has a brand new album out, and Nollaig has albums, and Mary has albums, and Gabe has albums. We all have albums. Bruce has them. And, oh yeah, you're on, Cathie. And I have them. And we know we did because we you know, everybody's buying cars now, and they don't give you CD players anymore. What the heck is going on with that? Every year when I got a new car, there's nowhere to play the bloody CD, and that's where I used to listen to all my music. So we made a USB. We've never done a USB before. We made a USB, and you could just stick it in your car, or you can stick it into your television, or you can stick it wherever the hell you want to stick it. But they're out there, and actually it's an album we called Ultimate Christmas Mix, and we have 40 tracks, over 3 hours of listening music on it, and I'm very proud of it. I think it's actually a lovely album. One of our Christmas albums was chosen by the New York Times as one of the top five Christmas albums of the year. We had Frank Sinatra on one side of us and Britney Spears on the other, so that was kind of cool. That doesn't happen every year. But anyway, they're out there as well. We only have a few, but they're out there. And folks, we want to let you know, myself and Mary are running a bus tour to Ireland. We have three tours going next year. Two of them already sold out. And we have just a few seats remaining for a third bus tour in July, June 28th to July 6th or something like that, around that time. And we have a ball in Ireland, I have to say. Bringing music every night. We see the sights and beautiful hotels and great food. So if you want to join us, Gabe is also doing one as well. That's with right. Scott Kirby, right. Different tour. But if you'd like to come, we'd love to come to Ireland with us. And also, I'm running my cruise. I'm going to go try to run our cruise again next September 4th to the 11th. We have over 500 people booked already. We're hitting. We're going to France and Italy and Spain and Corsica and Mallorca. And we're going to have fun. I don't care. We're going. Enough's enough. I'm sick of sitting down and being locked in a corner. We're vaccinated and boosted, and after I get boosted again, I'm going to get boosted and boosted till I can fly. All right? That's it. That's it. So listen, we're going to boost you one more time. We'd love you if you call our friend on Facebook, too. Facebook, we're Cherish the Ladies on Facebook. Cathie has a Facebook page as well. So if you want to join us there on Facebook, we'd love to hear from you. If you're having a good time, drop us a line. We'd love to hear from you. And if you took any sneaky pictures, send them, because we love to see what we look like. So we see who needs their pants ironed. All right, well, listen, we hope you're having a great time. We're having a great time with all of you. You doing all right down there? All right. Well, here's a very famous tune. Where's this from, Nollaig? Is it Cork or Kerry?
Czechoslovakia.
Oh, it's from Czechoslovakia. Okay. There's a great old Christmas carol called Good King Wenceslas. Here we go. One, two, three. Thank you. for 10 minutes. Thank you very much. Are you doing all right? Are you doing all right? Woo!
You're good. You're good.
Yeah. Doesn't look like you went too far. Well, we're back. It's so great, great, great to see you. Well, listen, what are we going to do here now? Oh, what's happening? Who's knocking over the what are those
false,
things?
Four false.
Well, we're so happy. We have a couple of guests tonight to join us here. And we're going to start off by inviting Gabriel's wife. She's a beautiful singer, Marion Makins. Would you give her a big round of applause to come up and join us? Where are you, Marion?
Who I'm related to by marriage.
Yeah. Where are you, Marion? She's in the bloody lobby.
It takes her a while sometimes.
You're holding up the show, Marion. How about them Yankees?
Oh, how about those Baltimore Orioles? I'd like to welcome Richie Bensells here tonight, trainer for the Baltimore Orioles for many years.
Oh, really?
With his lovely wife, Carol.
How you doing? Yankees are going to win.
It was a long trip in from the lobby.
How are the cats doing?
Oh, cats are great. I'll just take this opportunity to give a shout out to all the Temple Owls in the audience. That's right. That's right. I knew you were there.
Okay, what's this? What are you going to sing?
They're looking at me. I'm going to sing a song for you called The Song of Wandering Angus. And if we have any Yeats fans in the audience, you may know this. You may know it.
to the hazel wood, because a fire was in my head, and cut and peeled a hazel wand, and hooked a berry to a thread. And when white moths were on the wing, and moth-like stars were flickering out, I dropped the berry in a stream, and caught a little silver trout.
Beautiful tune from William Butler Yeats. Well, we're going to go back to some old classic Christmas carols right now for you. And we're going to feature Mary Coogan. And she's going to play a real classic. And it just sings and plays so well when Mary fingerpicks this on the guitar. And it's a lovely tune. I know you all know it. It's called What Child Is This? Here's Mary Coogan.
Thank you.
let's hear from Mary Coogan. On what child is this? Beautiful playing, Mary. And what about Mirella Murray on that accordion? Beautiful stuff, Mirella. Ripping it out, ripping it out. Woo! Woo! She's pulling out that squeeze box. Woo! Are you back again? Bruce and Cathie are back this time. We got two for the price of one.
That's it. It's a good deal.
It's a good deal.
Good value for money.
Are you singing a modern song this time, Bruce?
No.
Oh.
We're moving up from 1847. We're getting up to 1855.
Oh, good.
That's all right. The beautiful song here from Scotland, from the Hebrides. And there were enough songs about the nativity. You say, well, what happens after the nativity? And there's all those things about changing diapers and all those kind of things you have to do with the baby. And also about singing a lullaby, you know, to put the baby, child Jesus, to sleep. So a beautiful song here from Father Ronald Rankin.
New Christmas Eve was the first time this was sung.
Yes, yes. He was asked to put this together for that. So if you can imagine a lullaby, the Mother Mary singing this to Jesus, the Christ Child lullaby.
Are they going to sing with us on this one, Bruce?
I don't know if they're able, Joanie.
What's the chorus?
Tough chorus.
It's a tough chorus. It's tough. Okay, it's complicated. So listen up, all right? I'll give you a chance. Here's the words. Alleluia. 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 You with me so far? Alleluia.
Oh, we can handle that.
Okay. That's it, all right? So, and we're not looking for technique here. We're looking for volume and feeling, all right? So if you could help us out, we'd appreciate it.
Tender one are you, my sweet and lovely son are you. You are my love and darling you, unworthy I of you. Gentle eyes proclaim the loving heart from which you came. A tiny, tender, hapless babe with boundless grace of faith.
Hallelujah.
Eternal One, you are my God and helpless Son, high ruler of mankind. Hallelujah. my love and tender one. Are you my sweet and lovely son? Are you? You are my love and darling you, unworthy I.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
Angelic. Thank you.
There you go. Lovely singing from Bruce and Cathie once again. Lovely stuff. And yourselves, you weren't half bad. You're surprising us tonight. Well, I was telling you, everybody in the band, every one of us come from musical families, which is a wonderful thing. That's one of the greatest gifts that we got was from our parents and our brothers and our sisters and everybody. The music has been so important to all of our lives. And in my case, my music, as I was mentioning earlier, came from my father. He was a great accordion player, and he had a great big band in New York. And as soon as I could play two tunes, I was in the band. And I'm one of seven children, but we were very, very close. We had a special bond through the music, as you can imagine. But we were away on tour, and I got a call like 3 o'clock in the morning that my father had tripped going down the stairs, and he broke his neck on one step, and he passed away. I got home to say goodbye, thank God. But when we were leaving the hospital, my mother called me in my car, and she says, Joan, the hospital has just called, and they want parts of Dad. I said, Mom, Dad would want them to have whatever. If he could help somebody out after he was done with it, he'd want them to have it. And we completely forgot about it. And about 3 months after he passed away, we got a letter from the blind association telling us that he had given sight to two blind people with his eyes. So it was a wonderful, wonderful gift. So I do recommend everybody, if you're not an organ donor, do it. It's the most beautiful feeling to know you've helped somebody out afterwards. Well, anyway, I wrote this little tune when I found out about that, and I was thinking about Christmas time, and that's the gifts that we give that we don't pay for that are the greatest gifts. And I wrote this tune, and I called it To See You Once More. Hope you like it. Here's Nollaig to take it for you. Thank you.
and heaven and nature see.
Joy to the world, the Savior reigns, let men their songs imply. From fields and floods, from hills and plains,
repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy.
What about Bruce on the uilleann pipes? Beautiful. Well, we thought it'd be nice to get Gabriel to do a little song for you too. Would it be all right if we got Gabe singing one? He now makes his home in Philadelphia, so he's one of you now. Come on, right? Aren't you, Gabe? Are you one of them?
I'm one of you guys now. On a steady diet of cheesesteaks. So I thought we'd do something modern and do something from 1915. Is that okay? Actually, it's a song that was written in the 80s by a great songwriter named John McCutcheon from the Midwest. And he wrote it about Christmas 1915 when the troops on the Central Powers side and the German side and the Allied side stopped fighting for a few hours, and they actually played a game of soccer in no man's land. And you know, Ireland sent 200,000 soldiers off to fight in the trenches of Europe in World War I. They were told by the MP at the time, his name was John Redmond, that if they went to fight in Europe, they had a very good chance of getting home rule afterwards. Of course, the British had no intention of giving home rule. So the ones that stayed behind, the conscientious objectors, they actually formed the Irish Volunteers. And in my family, I had both. I had Thomas Donohue, who died from his wounds at Ypres in Belgium, and then my uncle Mike, who spent a couple of years as a guest of Her Majesty in the Wormwood Scrubs prison in London as an Irish volunteer. But anyway, this is a song called Christmas in the Trenches. It goes like this. Oh, my name is Francis Tolliver, and I come from Liverpool. 2 years ago, the war was waiting for me after school. To Belgium and to Flanders, to Germany, to here, I fought for king and country I held dear. It was Christmas in the trenches, where the frost so bitter hung. On the frozen fields of France was still, not a Christmas song was sung. Our families back in England, they were toasting us that day. They're brave and glorious lads so far away. I was lying with my messmates on the cold and rocky ground, when across the lines of battle came the most peculiar sound. I said, now
Listen up, ye boys, each soldier strain to hear, as one young German voice sang out so clear. Oh, he's singing bloody well, you know. My partner said to me, so one by one each German voice was joined in harmony. All the cannons rested silent then, and the gas clouds rolled no more, as Christmas brought us respite from the war. As soon as they were finished, and a reverent pause was spent, God rest you, merry gentlemen, sung up some lads from Kent. Well, the next they sang was Stille Nacht, 'tis Silent Night, says I. And in two tongues, one song filled up the sky. There's something coming towards us now, a front line sentry cried. A sight were fixed on one lone figure trudging through the night. And his truce flag like a Christmas star shone on the plain so bright, as he bravely strolled unarmed into the night. Soon one by one from either side marched into no man's land. With neither gun nor bayonet, we met there hand to hand. We shared some secret brandy, and we wished each other well. And in a flare-lit soccer game, we gave them hell. Well, we traded chocolates, cigarettes, and photographs from home. These sons and fathers far away from families of their own. Young Sanders played the squeeze box then, and they had a violin. What a curious and unlikely band of men. Some daylight stole upon us then, and France was France once more. With sad farewells we each began to settle back to war. Well, the question haunted every heart that lived that wondrous night. Whose family have I fixed within my sights? It was Christmas in the trenches, where the frost so bitter hung, and the frozen fields of France were warmed, the songs of peace were sung. All the walls they put between us to exact the work of war had been crumbled and were gone forevermore. Oh, my name is Francis Tulliver. In Liverpool I dwell, and each Christmas comes since World War I, and I've learned its lesson well. That the ones who call the shots won't be among the dead and lame. And in each end of the rifle we're the same.
Gabriel Donohue, everybody!
All the Ray Coleman fans over there.
We're going to bring things up to even now. Well, actually older than the last song by John McCutcheon that Gabriel sang so beautifully. This is a song that was written by Chester. I've got to get my lyrics just in case. Chester Hairston, he was, he really came to the fore in the late 1930s. He was a writer, he was a composer, and an arranger, and an actor. But his great love was the Negro spiritual, the black spiritual. That was his amen music, and he lived for it. and that's what he was renowned for. And he was invited to this birthday party, and he was asked to sing a song for the birthday person, and he thought, okay, let's do some calypso, let's make it fun. So he did that and put it behind him and went on to other things. And then the Hollywood Choir called him and invited him to contribute a song for a Christmas show. And he remembered the calypso song. And being the Amen man, it was no problem to put the nativity to that great calypso beat. And it just happened that night at the concert that Harry Belafonte was in the audience. And he fell in love with Mary's boy child and brought it to all of us. The magic happened then. And I'd like to sing this song especially for all of you for supporting us through a really hard time by being friends with us on Facebook and Twitter and in social media and being here tonight waiting for us to come back. It's been a really hard time. And I'm speaking personally now. I went through a really difficult time. And I had people like Cathie and Tony and Robin and Mike, who are here tonight, who would send texts and email messages every now and again and say, how are you? Are you holding up? Are you okay? Hang in there. And Robin sent me a prayer shawl, which kept me warm and hopeful. So will you join us in singing Mary's Boy Child? Oh, that was terrible.
Kathie,
we need a little calypso. You can move around in your seat. Yes, Gabriel. And we have to invite Mirella. She's going to play a beautiful tune that she wrote in honor of Sallaug, who is a brilliant fiddle player in Connemara's daughter, Liz Kane. And she could be watching this streaming. This child is desperate for a Cherish the Ladies live show. She went to bed one night crying because she missed everybody. So Mirella wrote her this beautiful tune. So Mary's Boy Child and Sallaug.
Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible says, Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a new king born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. New shining star, and heard a choir of angels sing. The music came from above.
Hark now, hear the angels sing. A new king born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
Joseph and his wife Mary came to Bethlehem that night. They found no place to bear her child, not a single room was in sight.
Hark now, hear the angels sing, a new king born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas. And in a manger cold and dark,
Mary's little baby was born. Trumpets sound and angels sing. Listen to what they say. That man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
Rise it up.
Hark now, hear the angels sing. A new king born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
Now let's hear it, Cathie Ryan. Gorgeous guys.
Thank you.
Well, listen, we have what? How are you doing? Are you all right? Can you stick a few more? Or are you done? All right. Okay. Well, we have another special guest to come up and play with us here tonight. He's a wonderful, wonderful local singer, and he's a very talented man. And Gabriel just produced one of his latest records.
That's right.
He has a brand new album out. I played on it too, and believe it or not, he paid me. He paid me with, he showered me with a bag of chocolate. That's what he meant.
He paid both of us, actually.
Is that what he paid? Did he pay you too, Gabe?
Oh my God,
that's amazing. No, he's a wonderful, wonderful singer, and we're so honored to have him. Ask him up to come up and sing a song with us. How about a big round of applause for Raymond Coleman? Come on, Raymond.
How's it going?
Beard is coming in nice, Ray.
Well, I'm trying to grow it. I said I was going to cut it this week, but the wife says don't do it, so I'll do what the wife tells me.
Wife likes it. Jackie's here tonight.
Yeah, she's right there at the front. Do this one for
Jackie. Yeah, this is date night, her coming to watch you sing.
That's twice this week I let her out. You know, she doesn't get out too often. There's a little song, it's on the album, it's a little song about going back to Ireland and getting around the table and singing a few songs and meeting up a few friends and getting drunk. Just that we're known to well done. But it's all about coming back to the USA, which is now my home away from home. And that's a Robbie O'Connell song as well, right?
Yes.
Cathie sang one earlier, so I says, Jesus, I may as well sing one too.
Called the other days expecting the royalties, Ray.
You never sent me over as PayPal. But it's all good. But I'll do this one. It's called My Home Away From Home.
Okay. Have we practiced one? Have we practiced this yet?
No.
Ah, well, that's all right. Just they can't get their money back now. It's too late.
Well, you guys backing me, I'm sure it'll be all right. Well, I didn't sleep at all last night, I stayed up till the dawn. Well, banging out the jigs and reels till everyone had gone. Well, singing some old shut-eyed songs I hadn't sung for years. Well, knocking back the brandy and the beer. And it's back across the ocean to my home away from home. I'm glad to be returning, but sad to have to go. I'd like to find a way to be two places at one time. It's easy going back again, but it's hard to say goodbye. Well, I packed one bag too many just as I was set to leave. I was loaded down with bacon and with sausages and tea. And I couldn't find my ticket as I'm walking out the door till I emptied all my bags out on the floor. And it's back across the ocean to my home away from home. I'm glad to be returning, but sad I have to go. I'd like to find a way to be two places at one time. It's easy going back again, but it's hard to say goodbye. Well, on board the plane, I sip a drink while waiting for the meal. Just trying not to let my head know how my stomach feels. Well, there's a baby right behind me, making sure that I won't sleep. And the flight's too full to find another seat.
Back across,
and it's back across the ocean to my home away from home. Well, I'm glad to be returning, but sad to have to go. Well, I'd like to find a way to be two places at one time. And it's easy going back again, but it's hard to say goodbye. Well, I fell asleep at last just as the plane was touching down. And I aged 10 years just waiting for the bags to come around. And I make it home at last, and I'm barely unpacked when I'm already making plans to go again. And it's back across the ocean to my home away from home. I'm glad to be returning, but sad to have to go. Well, I'd like to find a way to be two places at one time. And it's easy going back again, but it's hard to say goodbye. And it's back across the ocean to my home away from home. I'm glad to be returning, but sad to have to go. I'd like to find a way to be two places at one time. And it's easy going back again, but it's hard to say goodbye. That's on the new album. It'll be on social, all the social things next week. It's called The Postman Thinks I'm Crazy.
Is that the name of your record?
Yeah.
The Postman Thinks You're Crazy? Well, I think you're crazy. Let's hear for Raymond Coleman one more time. And I have to say, Raymond is fantastic. And he's coming on the cruise too, aren't you, Raymond?
Yes, sir.
Him and the brother, Mickey. Well, listen, we're going to get everybody up this time and do a little song for you. This is a song that I came about. I was very fortunate to play on Pete Seeger's solo album, one of his solo albums, the one that won the Grammy. And you remember Pete Seeger? Oh, yeah. Well, he was a great friend of the band's, and we were great friends of his. And I was so honored to play on his record. And we went up to Pete's house, when we were recording the album. I asked him, would he play on our record? And I went up to visit him, and I drove up his driveway. He lives on the top of a mountain in a log cabin that he built by himself. And he's 92 years old, and he's up there, and he's splitting logs when I pull up with an axe. But anyway, we recorded him in this house, and I wrote a check, and he ripped it up and threw it in my face. And I wrote another check, and he ripped it up. I said, no, Pete, seriously, I want to pay you. I paid everybody in the record. He says, Joanie, having you young folks play folk music is all the payment I want. That was Pete Seeger. What a beautiful man. But when we had the party at his house, he gave us all a book for the Grammy party. He gave us all a book when we were leaving. It was a beautiful looking book. And it was so beautiful, it sat on the top of my coffee table for years. And it wasn't until, again, we were making another Christmas album that I decided to go open it up and say, maybe Pete has something in there. And it was songs from all over the world. And there was an African-American religious song that was from the 1800s. And I found the song, and I loved the song. But it had two problems in my books. I didn't like the words, and I didn't like the music. But anyway, myself and Mary went at it. We wrote a couple of verses, and myself and Mirella, we horsed around. We came up with this melody, and somehow or other, it wound up in Cajun land. But it's one of these call and answer songs, and your line is, rise up, shepherd, and follow. Hello? Rise up, shepherd, and follow. That's all you got to do. Are you ready? Where's the dancers? Come on. What do you got? Kathy's got her washboard. Look at Kathy. Oh. And what do you got? What do you got? What do you got, Caitlin? And what do you got, Noel? Oh, stop with that now. That gets me hungry. Stop that. The dinner bell. Okay. Get in that mic, Noel. Get in the Piper's mic there with that. Sit down there and play your little jingle jangle into the there. Sit down there and go on, sit down. Go on, get comfortable. Just be in time, for God's sakes. We're going to send this out to our great friend down there, Rosemary Timoney, a woman who did so much for Irish dancing here in the Philadelphia area. So happy to hear she's here tonight. Rosemary, this is one that I could see you dancing around to. Here we go. There's a star in the east on Christmas morn. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. It'll lead you to the place where the Savior's born. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Follow, oh, follow. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Follow the star of Bethlehem. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Well, if you take good heed to the angel's words, rise up, shepherd, and follow. You'll forget your flocks, you'll forget your herds. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Follow, oh, follow. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Follow the star of Bethlehem. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. All right, girls! Heaven above,
rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Fulfill our hearts with joy and love.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Follow, oh, follow.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Follow the star of Bethlehem.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Well, now is the time for peace on earth.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Shine from us like the Savior's birth.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Follow, oh, follow.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Follow the star of Bethlehem.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Christmas morn,
rise up, shepherd, and follow.
It'll lead you to the place where the Savior's born.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Follow, oh, follow.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Follow the star of Bethlehem.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
I said follow, follow.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Follow the star of Bethlehem.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Here we go. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Triangle Man. Thank you very much for singing. Well, listen, I think you had enough now. Haven't you had enough? Oh, yes, you have. We got to drive back to Yonkers tonight. Get the heck out of here. But listen, did you have a good time? That's all we want to hear. Thank you so much to each and every one of you for coming out tonight. Thanks again to Matt. Would you give a big round of applause to Matt on sound? Thank you very much. Thanks for our lighting technician as well, and Beck. Beck, our hospitality manager, thank you so much. We love playing here. Not only is it a beautiful venue and you lovely people are so great to play for, but also the hospitality around here is second to none. They treat musicians so well, and I can't tell you how nice that is. Give them another round of applause. Thank you, Sellersville Theatre. So we're going to do one more for you, and we just want to say thanks a million for coming out tonight, and thanks to the Sellersville Theatre for being so great with taking care of everybody's self, health, and safety, and we're all feeling great being able to get out again. But we'd love to do one more. I'd like to dedicate this to our great friend Niall the Ogue down there, who handles all the bus tours. Thank you, Niall, for all you do. And we're going to love you and leave you with one of the greatest Christmas carols of all time, Silent Night. But again, we're going to feature Cathie. Cathie is going to sing the first verse in Irish for you. And what a pleasure to have Cathie Ryan with us one more time. Give her a big round of applause. Thank you, Cathie.
Thank you.
And Bruce Foley, just an honor to have the two of them singing with us. Thank you, Cathie, seriously. Hope you enjoyed. I hope you had a great time. Merry Christmas to all of you. Happy New Year. Happy Kwanzaa. Happy Ramadan. Happy Hanukkah. Happy whatever the hell makes you happy. That's all we want. And peace on earth and goodwill towards man. Thank you very much.
Goodwill. Let's all sing the first verse together, everybody. Join in.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant's
let's hear for Raymond Coleman, also Marion Makers, Cathie Ryan, and Bruce.
All right, get out of the way.
Gabriel Donohue, let's hear for Gabriel. Cathie Ryan, once again, Cathie. Woo! Bruce Foley down there, let's hear for Bruce. And I'm Joanie Madden. Merry Christmas, thank you. Came here. We love being in that lobby and hanging out with you all, but with the times we're in, we have a big tour. Unfortunately, you know the way it is. We can't, but we will shake hands next year. Thank you for coming out tonight. We had a ball with you tonight. Thank you so much. Thank you, Cathie. Thank you. Let's hear for Noel and Caitlin one more time. Good night. God bless. Safe home, everybody. Stay safe.
Merry
we'll
Christmas.
See you next year.